Tell me a story, please, Daddy.
The exponential function f of x equals 2 to the x can be plotted using...
No, I want a mathematical story.
Ah.
About caution and daring.
Let me tell you about the day daring almost exploded the entire solar system. It all started with a visit to a new pet store run by a strange-looking fellow named Bob.
What's in here? I don't see anything.
They're bacteria.
Oh.
They never need to eat, and as long as there is space in the jar, they double every minute. It's exactly 1 o'clock right now. Here's one bacterium in your jar. At 1:01, you'll have 2 bacteria. At 1:02, you'll have 4. And each purchase of 1 pet bacteria comes with 3 extra jars for free.
Wow. Thanks.
But just as she got to the door, the pet store owner offered a strange warning.
Whatever you do, don't let the jar get full. If the bacteria fill up the jar, they die. And then the jar explodes.
Derring felt a little nervous about that detail and thought about giving the jar back. But the bacteria were so small, she thought she'd have plenty of time before the jar got full. Kashun wasn't too enthusiastic about the new pets.
Look what I got at the pet store.
I don't see anything.
They're bacteria.
Ah, why would you do that? Haven't you heard of E. coli? Salmonella?
Relax. These are no ordinary bacteria. They're magic.
Magic?
Yep. They don't need any food, and as long as there is space in the jar, they double every minute. I started with 1, then I had 2, then 4, then 8. Take a look.
There's 16 of them now.
Aren't they cute? They're perfect pets.
What happens when they fill up the jar?
Oh, we can't let that happen.
Why not?
If there's no space in the jar, all the bacteria die, and then the whole jar explodes.
How long before the jar fills up?
Probably years. Don't worry, we'll just give some of them away. Bob gave me 3 extra jars for free.
Kashun measured the bacteria and the jar and the rate of growth. If the bacteria doubled every minute, the jar would be full at exactly 2 o'clock, only 1 hour away. Here's a puzzle for you. If the jar started with 1 bacteria at 1 o'clock and is going to be completely full at 2 o'clock, when would the jar be half full? So, when will the jar be half full?
1:30?
1:59.
Whoa!
At 1:30, there were 1,073,741,824 bacteria, but they barely formed a layer of scum on the bottom. And Derring was sure that Kashun had made a mistake in his calculations.
Derring, we have a big problem.
Oh, who's a good pet? These bacteria are good pets.
We're going to be in huge trouble.
Pshaw, don't be ridiculous. You can't even see them without the magnifying glass.
At 1:55, the bacteria filled 3% of the jar. A bacteria named Euclid realized the predicament and tried to convince his fellow bacteria of their peril. Stop dividing! We're going to run out of room in 5 minutes.
We've always done things this way. Don't be an alarmist.
We have 31 times more empty space than full. That's plenty.
But they wouldn't listen.
Your ideas make us uncomfortable.
Lock him up.
They'd always done things this way before.
Problem solved.
Each minute, the bacteria doubled again and again. And then, at 1:59, the jar was half full. That's the awesome power of exponential growth. The slow build to an explosive upward curve.
Ah, it's half full. We've got to take it outside so the explosion doesn't burn down the house.
Relax, I'll just split them into these other jars.
How much extra time will the bacteria survive now that there are 4 jars?
A few more hours?
Nope. They fill up the jars in only 2 more minutes.
Have I got a deal for you? It's a 1-day sale. 28 extra jars for only $9.99.
We'll take them.
Oh no.
Phew, this will buy us lots of time.
Stop! You're just delaying the inevitable explosion!
If they keep putting bacteria into jars, how much time will they have before all 32 jars explode?
5 hours?
5 minutes.
Ah! I see your jars are almost full again. Can I interest you in a magic device that will automatically duplicate a jar and move half the bacteria into it when the jar reaches half full? Only $25, and the bacteria will never explode. No, it would destroy the planet. Look at the data. In a half hour, the bacteria would cover the entire Earth in a layer of jars 2 meters thick. In an hour, they'd reach out to the sun. Death, destruction, planet collapsing into a neutron star.
Ah!
Or you might be interested in my flying stickers. Attach them to the jars and they'll rise up 400 feet in the air. Keep yourself and your loved ones safe from explosions for a minimum monthly payment of $49.95. Quick, not a moment to lose.
And that is how Derring almost destroyed the solar system. Fortunately for everyone, Kashun knew enough math to model the exponential growth and save the day.
What about the bacteria?
Well, it just so happens that there's one left. Would you like it?
No, get that thing out of here!
And now, our favorite part.
Do we have new patrons on the table?
We do.
Yay!
A warm welcome to Craftium, a Science Mom supporter who enjoys embroidery and collecting Legos.
Ooh, I love this card.
Be the first to guess the tune of the song correctly and you'll win a prize.
Yes, leave a comment if you recognize the tune.
Sergium and Angelium, Leilonium and Huvium, Kid on Bethium, Ikeum, Junium, and then Ulepium. Amandite, Noelanium, Devonite, and Cavicium, Acartanium, and Joyous Cypridondite, and Pinamite. Carolinium, Craftian, Meganese, Angelicum, Balithium, Kendrite, Draken, Pacini, followed by Cochranite. Denisium, we're almost done, finally Aprilium. They're the periodic table of Science Mom patrons.